Hey, what's up, everyone? I'm Paul Wontorek. Did anyone know what we were just listening to? What were we just listening to? Come on, somebody tell me. Because you should all be ashamed of yourselves that something happened yesterday. Anyone? What was that? What was that music we were just listening to? Somebody said it before. It was Honeymoon in Vegas. It closed. It sucks. That's the saddest thing today because, you know, the Tony nominations aren't even out yet. They're out in like, what, 3-4 weeks? And it could have gotten Best Musical, and it still could, but you can't go see it. Anyway, we are live at 5. We're going to go around and say hi to everyone. And we're using this Periscope thing. So I hope you guys like this Periscope thing because I think it's kind of fun. Did anyone watch Mad Men? Any Mad Men fans? Give me some hearts. I love the hearts. There's some hearts. I don't really understand the hearts on Periscope, but yeah, it was Honeymoon in Vegas. You're right. Okay, now you got it. Yeah. Honeymoon in Vegas. Poor Honeymoon in Vegas. It still lives on here. I'm still playing it. Does anyone watch Mad Men? Any Mad Men fans? I hope you saw Elizabeth Moss on Show People. She was like one of my favorite guests I've had on in quite a while. She's so much fun. She wants to do musicals. You guys gonna go see her her Norma Desmond in like 20 years? Anyone? Norma Desmond? I got a lot of hearts. Hearts are fluttering. Okay, so this is our office, and this is look, Broadway.com. That's a TV. Broadway.com. Look, this is where we film, right? Broadway.com. Look, this is just photos. People, we're gonna say hi to people. All right, I'm glad you're giving hearts. This is a photo of Darren Criss that doesn't currently have a home. So I don't know if anyone has a home for it. Hi, Natalie. How you doing? Thanks for saying hi. Hi, Natalie. So this is Beth Stevens. Look, she's at a standing desk.
I like to stand up.
Some people have standing.
I do have a chair.
She has a chair if she needs it. But Beth, what's going on? What are you doing?
I'm writing two things at once.
You have two things, literally, just two things.
I'm multitasking.
Open at once.
And I'm writing in code because it's a website, so I do that.
Right, yeah.
It's all secretive.
What are you writing about?
I'm writing about a playwright.
Yeah, is it a secret?
I don't know, is it a secret?
It's not a secret. We can tell people. We're gonna tell people things.
I interviewed Joe DiPietro.
Who wrote one of my favorite musicals, Memphis.
Memphis, your favorite musical.
So yeah, I love Memphis.
That. Memphis lives in Paul.
Yeah.
He wrote Living in Love. I got to go to his apartment and meet his two dogs and his boyfriend, but mostly the two dogs. And so I'm writing about that, and then I'm writing the script for the Broadway.com show.
Oh, the Broadway.com show. Yeah, that's what we do. Mondays at 3 o'clock. You're never going to see that meeting. That's not necessarily camera ready, but that's when we discuss each week's Broadway.com show. Her segments.
My script. Right now I'm writing about Linda Lavin.
And there's something else exciting. We have a new vlogger.
We have a new vlogger, which I'm totally excited
Me
about.
Too.
It's Jason Biggs.
Yes.
And Paul.
Who's in the Heidi Chronicles, which is awesome.
I love the Heidi Chronicles. Go see the Heidi Chronicles. But before you do that, watch Jason Biggs' vlog. It's called The Scoop, because he plays Scoop Rosenbaum. I'm sure you already know that.
We all know people named Scoop. It's such a common name.
Especially Jews named Scoop. Lots of Scoop Rosenbaums out there.
Of course.
Yeah. And celebrating Passover. And so Paul and I got to go to Jason's dressing room at the Music Box Theater.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so nice.
Mm-hmm.
He like painted it gray, right? And he got this like nice sofa. So you'll probably get to see it in the blog. Vlog.
Yeah.
And that starts on Thursday, the
9th. World premiere on Thursday. The Scoop. Jason Biggs.
Really excited.
No apple pies. No apple pies or no.
No.
Just
we don't have to talk about that.
Broadway.
Yeah,
talk about Broadway. Well, I'm going to go. Somebody loves the Music Box Theater. Somebody loves the blogs. Thank you for loving the blogs.
We love the blogs.
Providing the blogs.
We do.
All right. Is there anything like top secret on your screen? If I like showed,
no,
like a sneak peek.
Oh, don't. What?
You could read. Pippin was amazing. Benj, thanks for sharing. Pippin was amazing.
Yeah, Pippin was amazing. Great.
And it's on the road. It's still amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So go see it. All right. Let's go next door.
So see you next time. I'll probably be sitting that time.
Yeah. She may sit sometimes. There's a little orange dot that we can sit on for you. Somebody said nice office, so.
Thank you.
All right, yeah. So then this is where the blondes.
The blondes.
Yeah, Imogen Lagoever, who's your champion, and Ryan Lee Gilbert. So, what's going on in here? Imogen, news editor, Imogen Lagoever.
I mean, the excitement, and this is my Kermit ring, because I love Muppets.
Oh yeah, she does. She loves Muppets.
The office got me this last week for my birthday. There was a cake with it. It wasn't just a plastic ring.
Right.
This is my cake.
So what's the news? What's the buzz?
So for people my age, very old, Alicia Silverstone, who was in Clueless, she's coming off Broadway in June to MTC.
I'm excited
about that.
She's good.
She's good. We love her.
Yeah, she's good.
She's also been on Broadway. She was in The Graduate, those other things. So we love her.
Mm-hmm. And I love how she talks.
Really?
She has a very specific way of talking, right? She has specific. She has like a talk. Yeah. We like that.
She's adorable. So she's coming. We love her. Hopefully, maybe she can come do show people.
Maybe she'll come do show people.
That'd be a good thing.
That'd be fun.
Then Act of God with Christopher Fitzgerald.
Wait, somebody just wished you a belated happy belated birthday.
Thank you very much.
Happy birthday.
I'm 24. 24. And then
someone else just asked, where's your cowboy hat? So I actually see it. Imogen is our resident British cowgirl. She's very excited for the Hee Haw musical.
Very excited for Hee Haw and the SpongeBob musical. They're my favourites. Okay, so moving on to Broadway.
Yeah.
Jim Parsons is coming into Broadway to do an Act of God, which is very naughty, very blasphemous. We're going to love it. It's going into Studio 54, which is obviously a very holy place. Anyway, we now know who are going to be the angels in Jim Parsons, who's playing the Almighty, Christopher Fitzgerald and Tim Kaczorinski.
Yeah, that's the Saturday Night Live guy.
And then Christopher's had a couple of Tony nominations, so,
So that's it. You don't have to read any news on a site. You just recap.
That's
basically, it's not really a heavy news day.
No.
It's a medium news day.
Medium news day.
Yeah.
Wasn't too bad.
Medium news day. Yeah. People like the hat.
I've got to wear the hat.
And look, she's British.
I am British.
There's a flag.
Yes.
There's a flag.
I love a flag. Oh, yes, you know.
I'm an American flag with it.
I'm a British cowboy with a flag, yeah.
Okay, and if anyone has, you do know Fitzgerald is Bach. That's right. Anyone who's ever in Wicked is forever associated with Wicked.
No, but hang on a minute. Who else? Yes, there was someone else that I wrote about. It will come back to me. We'll get back to that.
If anyone has any questions, just feel free to just type them in. We like the hearts, though. The hearts are fluttering.
Oh, we love that.
Yeah. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna come to you in a minute. Look at the sofa. It's a nice sofa there.
We love our sofa.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hey, what's up, Paul?
Now,
how are you?
I hear a rumor that you like Hedwig and the Angry Inch.
Oh my gosh, it's my favorite. Hedwig is the best ever. How many times have you seen it?
You want to confess that, or are you embarrassed?
I don't even know anymore. I'm not kidding you. I have no idea. I think I saw it 4 times off Broadway when I was really young. I was like 14. And then I think I may have seen it.
Jeffrey Kerr just said hi, Lindsay.
Hey, what's up?
Right. Yeah, I'm just saying.
I might have seen it. You know what? It's too embarrassing.
All right, somebody wants to know who your favorite Hedwig is.
Oh, Joan Cameron Mitchell, hands down.
Hello.
Getting to see it was unbelievable.
Yeah.
100%.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Neil was great. They were all great, though.
Yeah. Wait. Who's your dream Hedwig? The questions are flying
in.
This is Terry. This is Terry, our receptionist. Hi, Terry.
I got a package from Terry. Very exciting.
You got some mail. People still send mail. Hard mail.
Yeah.
Not just emails.
I think I got a book.
The Walnut Street Theater loves a hard envelope.
Yeah. My dream Hedwig, I'm just going to say it right now, Adam Lambert. I love Adam Lambert. I think he would be great. I'm kind of shocked he hasn't played it yet.
Yeah, me too.
I feel like he would be like,
that's good. Really somebody good. Loves your dress.
Oh, thank you.
It's good for the ego.
Come on. Awesome.
They love the Adam Lambert.
Love Adam Lambert.
People are Adam excited Lambert. About Adam Lambert.
Okay,
yes.
Are you ready for this photo? Oh
my God,
this?
Yes. This is. Okay. Oh my God, this is so epic. Did you guys see this?
This is the most epic photo.
So Bruce Glickas took this photo. Look how epic. Look, it's all of them.
So Darren Criss coming in soon. NPH, obviously. Yep. I like Darren's hand placement there. That looks good.
This guy?
JCM.
He's the shortest one, JCM.
Yeah, he is.
And look, Randall's mate. Who has the biggest head? It's hard to say. Well, Darren Criss, he's pretty loud.
Yeah. It's a toss-up between Andrew Rannells and Darren Criss.
Yeah. I love this. This is like, this feels like the Smithsonian. Like, this is, hopefully they'll Adam Lambert will go on the end because hopefully he'll take over next.
Yeah. Oh, totally. That'd we could Photoshop him right in here.
It's
totally
there.
Okay, that would be good.
So, thank you. Thank you for letting us put the cameras on you.
Anytime.
What are you up to?
Well, I'm really excited. I'm from
Connecticut. Brian Lee Gilbert, our national editor.
Yes.
You might know him from the Broadway.com show.
Maybe. If you watch. Yes, hopefully you are.
I watch.
I'm from Connecticut and I'm a huge Alfred Hitchcock buff. That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right. Your brother went to UConn, right? I went to UConn.
Somebody wants Adam Pascal as Hedwig. I give that a thumbs up. All right.
And they just announced today that the stage adaptation of Rear Window is going to get a world premiere in Hartford at the Hartford Stage. So I'm a huge Hartford Stage buff. And Draco Treznik. Who directed Darko Treznik, I believe.
Yeah.
So directed A Gentleman's Guide to Murder.
Who has the coolest name on Broadway.
Has the best name on Broadway.
Yes.
Just won a Tony Award. He's directing Rear Window at the Hartford Stage. And fingers crossed, it'll come to Broadway. Sweep again, just like A Gentleman's Guide did. So I feel like he's on a roll lately.
That's a movie basically about watching your neighbors through
the
windows.
But spying on your neighbors, yes.
Spying on your neighbors.
Absolutely, absolutely.
That's a classic New York story.
Like just looking out and spying and maybe catching a murder. That's exciting.
This is, has it ever happened to you? What do you see out your window?
Never. I do have a woman across from me who likes to sort of bathe. Well, she bathes naked like we all do.
You're watching a naked lady?
Well, she just refuses to put up anything in the window.
We've got all sorts of exclusives on here.
She just doesn't have a curtain. And she has a plant that's dying that I can always see her naked near. And I don't know who I feel worse for, the plant or this woman who's just exposed to my...
Why don't you send her a curtain?
Well, I live in not the nicest neighborhood in Brooklyn, so I don't know if we can just be sending
things. Jennifer Mudge was wondering if you're her neighbor. Jennifer Mudge, are you naked in the window? Congratulations on your Lortel nomination, Jennifer Mudge.
If you're from Crown Heights, Brooklyn, then you are my neighbor, and we probably have to have a conversation. But otherwise, yeah.
We're thrilled for you, Jennifer Mudge. It's very exciting.
That is very exciting.
Oh, look, and there's look at this. Look at this, Mudge. Look at this magnet. Look at that Into the Woods magnet.
On my desk.
See that? on our metal desks. So, Biggie Smalls the Musical. Jennifer Mudge is a fan of nakedness and a partner. Okay.
Yeah.
Somebody wants to know, Imogen, you have to answer this.
Uh-oh.
I'm coming to New York in May and I'm seeing the audience. How do I meet Helen Mirren?
Oh. Well, you probably stand at the stage door, actually, don't you? Let me have a think. I think there are some restaurants that she likes.
Stage door might work.
Well, stage door might work.
I have some inside info.
Okay. Uh-oh.
The two girls that play young Queen Elizabeth in the show.
I met them today.
Yeah, we went over to the Skylark. It was awesome. Elizabeth Teeter and Sadie Sink, and they were saying that Helen Mirren actually doesn't get a lot of action at the stage door, surprisingly, and everyone's very polite, very demure about Helen Mirren walking down the street. So you can actually just probably go right up and meet her at the stage door.
Do you think she would appreciate like hysterical people at the stage door?
I
don't know. She's a dame. Isn't she a dame?
She rides the subway, though.
She rides the subway. We've all seen the photos. She rides the subway. All right, let's go out here. Thanks, guys.
Bye.
You get those hearts fluttering. All right, this is... hey, Caitlin. This is Caitlin, our photo editor. She just shot those little children.
Sadie and
girls.
Elizabeth.
They're very poised little girls, aren't they?
Yes, from the audience. They're amazing.
Did you like them?
I did. They were so cute, and they're all so creative. They're learning so many different crazy things right now. They do drawing, and one girl is learning about photography, and another one is taking ballet lessons.
Wow.
They're just like, they're the craziest, busiest little kids on Broadway.
You were also, what else do you want to talk about? You're talking about, we don't have interns right now. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. We'd love to have you here, but we don't have interns right now. We don't have a spot. Didn't you, you were talking before about that video, that crazy video.
Oh, Anne Hathaway?
Yeah, did everyone see the Anne Hathaway video?
Anne Hathaway is going to be on Lip Sync, this new TV show, which I believe Ryan informed me is a spinoff Jimmy Fallon's awesomeness. And basically, Anne Hathaway dresses up like Miley Cyrus and just sings Wrecking Ball all over the place.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty serious.
So, Ryan McPhee, news hound, Ryan McPhee, you know what's really sad today?
Yeah, bringing things
I feel like you need to educate people. You're actually very young, but sometimes you act a little older than you are. And you had to write.
I'm 14.
You had to write an obituary today for Julie Wilson. Julie Wilson, like I know Julie Wilson because I'm older, and I actually
I saw her on Broadway, and oh, look, there's it.
There we go.
Poor Julie Olson, she died at the age of 90.
She was a Tony nominee.
But who is she? Explain who she is to these people.
She was a Tony nominated Broadway performer. She had a very famous cabaret career as well.
Yeah.
And while researching her for the obituary, I was looking at a bunch of YouTube clips of her performing.
What's like a good go-to? What should people look up on
YouTube?
Okay,
well, here's the thing. I didn't know that she, in addition to Broadway, also appeared in the national tours of 3 Sondheim musicals. She was in Follies, Company, and at A Little Night Music.
Wow.
And there are a couple clips of her, actually, online of her performing songs from those shows. I actually have one right here.
Look at that.
Here she is singing Ladies Who Lunch.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she played Joanne in the first
episode.
Listen to her.
She also always had that. She was always rocking that bun.
Yeah.
And the flower.
If you look,
in her
if you
bun.
Google image her, every picture.
Oh my God,
she
I
has
love.
That look.
I used to see her all the time.
That's
and, yeah, she's a great lady, and she was also in. I saw her in the Peter Allen musical Legs Diamond.
Uh-huh. That's what she received her Tony nomination.
Oh right.
That was the last time she appeared on Broadway.
Yeah. So R.I.P. Julie Wilson. Yeah. Everyone needs to go online and educate yourselves.
Yeah. Do you
do some Google searching. Some Google searching. What does this sticky mean?
Poll.
Oh, that's just a little reminder for me to
do
engage
poll.
Our readers, ask them questions in our stories.
Okay.
So look out for that.
Okay, good. And we also have Amy Morton's head.
There's oh, yeah, of course.
Our office has a lot of crazy things, including this guy. This is Hoots.
I'm watching a Periscope video.
Oh, you're watching it live? That's weird. So there's a delay.
I'm trying to watch a Periscope video right now.
That's crazy. What do you, oh, look at you.
That's just my desktop background. It's just it's a desktop background. It's me and Elizabeth Moss. Just a normal thing that I have that maybe no one else in the world would have.
Uh-huh.
You know, and we're matching. So I don't know if you notice we're matching.
Yeah, I know. The match is the
we're
yellow.
Matching.
There's like a yellow and then
yeah,
a pink.
We called each other that day. And just we didn't really call each other. We had breakfast and then we just chatted about what we'd wear. And just took a rad picture. So
yeah, she was nice, huh?
She's so nice.
She was really sweet.
She's very cool.
She was a lot of fun. Oh, look, you're on.
It's very meta.
It's so weird.
Very meta. This is like, what's happening right now?
It's weird.
What?
It's freaking me out.
Yeah, all right.
It's freaking me out. Joanne, do you have anything you want to say? This is site producer Joanne Villani.
Hello.
Joanne's been here. Joanne's worked here for, I think, 34 years.
I don't think it's been that long. So. But
how long has it been?
It's been 11 in June.
It's been a long time.
Yeah, long time.
Yeah,
long time.
Long time. And yeah.
Yes.
What are you up to? What are you
well,
doing?
Well, I saw today that we finally saw a picture of Christian
Borle.
Oh my
God. Borle yeah, I've been waiting.
Costume for Something Rotten.
So Christian Borle plays Shakespeare.
That's
Something
Shakespeare,
Rotten.
Apparently.
Oh, you do see Newsies. Yeah, there are Newsies
yeah,
on, the
wall,
on the wall, everybody. There are Newsies, yes.
Yeah.
But look at Christian Borle.
Yeah, I like the guy.
He is a rock star.
There's a nice guy liner going on there. Nice conversation piece going on there. About here.
Yeah. This guy's not in the show. This guy's not in the show. That's Harvey Firestone. He is, what is he working on? They just announced something.
Isn't he doing the book for something? He's
yes.
doing the book for...
Quiz? Pop quiz?
Oh,
what's Harvey writing the book for?
The
book
for...
The new NBC Quiz.
The Wiz.
Yeah.
The Wiz.
Yes.
That's so he clearly was doing research on comedy at Something Wrong.
Yes.
So yeah, Christian Borle looks good.
Well, I mean, they all do.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah.
It's good.
I'm excited.
I'm excited too. It's a really good show, everybody. These are the video guys. What are you working on, Alex? Oh, look, Alex is it's a sneak preview of next week's show, people.
Yeah, there we go.
Who's that guy? Who's that guy? Nick? Nick, what's going on? You had a birthday this weekend.
Thank you.
How was
much.
It?
It was great. I had a great time.
Who's that girl over? Yeah, Emily Rosenfeld.
Oh, yeah.
From Annie.
It's kind of disgusting. He has a picture of a young girl over his desk.
People are excited about that. Show people, Alex. So don't lose the footage.
Hey, everyone.
People are excited.
Can't look at this. This is
oh, there's some secret projects happening.
Yeah, it's dirty.
This is a legendary photo. Look at that, everybody. That's opening night.
Can we show him Danza? And
legendary.
Can we show him this?
Legendary. And this one is one of my favorites. Look at this from Rehearsals of Hair. Will Swenson. Gavin Creel, Casey Lee, come on.
Can we show him Danza?
How good is that? How good is that?
All
right, I think
we show him Danza.
Oh, this is, it's R.I.P. It's R.I.P. Honeymoon in Vegas. This is one of our favorite McClure Danza moments.
Yeah, show them.
They make the round. They make the round.
Oh, you want to see the inside of the closet?
Show them the inside of the closet.
The what?
The Hall of Fame inside the closet.
We'll show them the closet another day.
Oh.
All right. Well, thank you, everyone, for joining us. Yeah, live at 5. This is Broadway.com. This is what happens here. So keep watching, and maybe we'll do this if you like it. I don't know. Do you like it? Give us more heart.